Okay, it's a misty morning here. It's sort of a real autumn morning. We haven't had much of an autumn. It was very late starting this year. I'll just give a report of where things are at with the mucking around with cover crops here on the farm at Wurraglen. Down here, we've got the way I had this paddock in over summer. You'll see that it's a mixture of tropical grasses. There's a lot of Rhodes grass and panic and stuff in here. And Tinneroo glycine mainly, there's a bit of lab, so it's a very dense mix of legumes and grasses, and usually this time in the autumn the grasses slow down and the legumes take off and I can get a really big legume cover, so I'm quite happy with that. That's fixing a lot of nitrogen, that's pumping a lot of sugars into the soil, and when we're ready to come into this area hopefully we'll be able to deal with the perennial plants. The next thing up here is went through and we flail mulched this same material down, and it's grown back very, very quickly with a bit of rain, and you can see the tropical grasses here, all the clumping grasses. This is mainly Gatton Panic, has come up and it's a dark green, so it's actually trapping some of that nitrogen that was down in the soil, and it's come up, you know, it's doing its job of sort of not letting that nitrogen leach away because we had some quite heavy rains, and I think this helped hang on to that. So this area now is going to provide a magnificent mulch, but we will probably need to tarp it because obviously being a perennial grass, and if it's warm this winter, which it probably will be, it'll continue growing and get in the road. So we'll probably tarp it and then put in a crop under this cover, but that'll produce an awful lot of mulch cover for us. So this area here, as we've cut down, we'll probably tarp it. It's got a whole pot of bulbs deep underground, but unfortunately it got taken over with perennial summer grasses and everything. And so we'll probably tarp it, try and get the grasses and the other weeds down, and then hopefully our expensive bulbs will come up through the mulch. We'll see how that experiment goes. And up here we've got a little trial of different cover crop seeds. This is an area which had been tarped earlier, and we just tried a whole mix of little cover crops to see which ones, how they go at this time of year. So we had an unsuccessful planting of lupins, Luxor lupins. That was a problem with the seed rather than anything else. Persian clover has come up pretty well. That's turbo Persian clover. It'll start getting a go on now that the cooler weather's coming. We planted a summer mix very late, even though it was in autumn. We planted a summer mix from AGF seeds, and that's been quite a good performer. That's a real mix of plants and radishes and sorghums and a few legumes, some fodder rape. We put in tillage radish, which was a an affordable version of daikon radish, really, and of course it's taken off really quick. You can see all this area is very pale green. We're very short of nitrogen here. We've had, you know, flooding rains, and this area had been in production up till last year, so very short of nitrogen. That's why the legumes are so important. We tried planting some molokia, just roughly thrown in. Not been a success, probably because of old seed. We've grown molokia in the past, and there's some plants in there, but pretty poor germination, and might be getting a bit cool for them. Even though this doesn't look like a success, it was. It's a planting of sun hemp, which germinated and took off really fast, but unfortunately it's the favourite food of the garden's hares. We must have some hares in here, and all they've done is sit and chew off and eat out the global sun, its cradle area junk here. So we have, it's germinated well, got growing well, but haven't solved the problem of the hares leaping through the fence and coming and eating it. A surprise that we had here is we had a failed crop of okra, also a bit late and probably old seed, so I threw out some chia seed just bought from the supermarket, and the chia has germinated very quickly and is growing very, very fast. So got hope that some of the Malvaceae would be able to use as cover crops. The Molokia has grown well here in the past. Chia might be interesting. So that's a sum of where we've got. On the other side of the paddock is an area that's just come off, had the tarps lifted, and we're using the mulch underneath that and planting beans and things straight through the mulch. So that's the summary of where things are at with the mucking around with cover crops at Wurraglen today.